Hello everybody, welcome to Anablox. We have some exciting things to talk about in this video, and the topic we'll be focusing on today is the top 10 times anime characters lost all control. But of course, before we dive into this video, I've got a question for you. Have you subscribed to this channel yet? If you aren't, you're missing out on quite a lot here. So make sure to subscribe so that you will always get the latest information about anime from us. Anyways, like I said in the beginning, let's dive right into this video. Starting with number 10, we have Ryuko from Kill la Kill. Ryuko was furious for a variety of reasons. When Nui Harime confessed that she was responsible for Ryuko's father's death, Senketsu, overcome with rage, changed her into a monstrous creature with distorted features that would attack anybody. Fortunately, Mako was able to save her friend from going insane. Next up at number 9, we have Ichigo from Bleach. Ulquiorra was an unprecedented juggernaut that Ichigo had no chance of defeating in his base form. Refusing to die, he transformed back into his hollow state and gained such incredible strength that for the first time in the series, his opponent truly expressed shock. Orihime and Uryu, the latter of whom was unintentionally hurt amid the substitute Soul Reaper's bloodlust, found his ethereal screams and insufferable mannerisms to be equally horrifying. At number 8, we have Shinra. Shinra's body was somewhat under the control of the first pillar, an evil force. She was able to exploit his growing insecurities for his monstrous smile and the death of his family. He attacked one of the fire stations in his rage and came dangerously close to killing their Adola-obsessed commander. Moving on to number 7, we have Killua from Hunter x Hunter. In the final rounds of the Hunter exam, Killua lost control due to the sneaky influence of Illumi Zolidic. Although he had no trouble winning, he violated the only guideline Isaac Nitiro established. No matter what, do not kill the other competitor. He was the sole test taker to have failed the final section, ironically, not for lack of merit. But years later, he would retake the exam and succeed the second time around. Heading to the sixth character, it's Naruto. Before Naruto was capable of harnessing the power of Kurama, Kurama was more capable of controlling him under extreme states of duress. Through his conflict with Orochimaru, he demonstrated this. Naruto had previously lost control. Jiraiya had also been hurt while working with him to defeat the Akatsuki. Fortunately, the young man's primal rage could be subdued and brought back to the reality of Captain Yamato using his Hashirama cells. Diving to number 5, we have Polnareff. Anubis was a mischievous stand who had the power to possess whoever held him. Although Polnareff was aware of its evil tendencies, he would eventually fall victim to them and be turned against his villagean ally, Jotaro Kujo. During a battle, even Star Platinum was soon overwhelmed with dizzying attacks and unprecedented speed. However, was able to return his friend to normal by catching the evil sword in his stomach and crushing it in his hands. Next up at number 4, we have Eren from Attack on Titan. Eren harnessed his Titan form for the first time with the express purpose of saving humanity during his first mission to patch a hole in one of Paradis's damaged walls. But as soon as he turned into the Attack Titan, he dove for Mikasa and attempted to crush her. This was bad news for everyone because it showed that Jaeger's critics were right. He obviously lacked self-control. Fortunately, this was the only time Eren's savagery was displayed. Heading towards the third character, it's Meliodas from Seven Deadly Sins. Fraudrin, a Ten Commandments demon, was in charge of manipulating Hendrickson. He was on the verge of dispatching his adversaries during their direct combat when Grimoire begged him to hold off. He held back from attacking Dreyfus and vowed not to hurt anyone else after being overwhelmed by the memories of the two of them he had shared once. But in a single punch, Meliodas vaporized everything above his waist after losing control. Next up at number 2, we have Roy Mustang from Fullmetal Alchemist. The passing of Roy Mustang's close friend Maze Hughes infuriated him. When he discovered the perpetrator, he would finally exact revenge on Lust in their conflict. He relentlessly smothered her in fire until she was no longer able to heal her wounds, despite the fact that her Philosopher's Stone allowed her to regenerate from his scorching attacks. And finally at number 1, we have Gon. After Kite's passing, Gon underwent a permanent transformation. Gon, who was devastated by his friend's death, snapped and filled himself with all the power he would ever possess. hoping to use it to defeat Neferpitu. Their fight was ultimately brutal, one-sided, and short, but Gon would live to feel the effects of it. That's it for today. If you guys enjoyed the video, make sure to hit the like button. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on that notification bell so you never miss out on any future content we'll produce for you guys. We're signing off now, but we'll be sure to catch you all in the next one.